Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope all are fine. Welcome back to the class. Children, in previous class, we learned about the motion and we learned about the relative, and motion is also a relative, and we learned some examples of that relative, and we learned the distance and displacement also. Yes or no? So, and we learned the scalar quantities and vector quantities also. In previous class, I told some examples of scalar quantities also. What are the examples of scalar quantities? Means time, temperature, mass, length, area, volume, density, speed, work, power, and energy, etc. are the examples of scalar quantities. And what are the examples of vector quantities? Displacement, velocity, acceleration, weight, force, momentum, impulse, etc. are the examples of vector quantities. Clear, children, up to here? And now today we are going to discuss average speed and average velocity. So once see this figure, children, in your textbook is there. So here a train named Godavari Express. What is the train name? Godavari Express. It starts 5 p.m. When it starts? It starts 5 p.m. 5 p.m. means post p.m. means post meridian. From where it starts? From Visakhapatnam and reaches to Hyderabad. When? At 5 a.m. a.m. means anti meridian. In the next day, here see this figure. Everybody, once see this figure. So, Visakhapatnam to Vijayawada and Vijayawada to Hyderabad and from Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad. So, now let the distance of the entire trip from Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad be 720 kilometers. Total trip 720 kilometers. So, the journey time is 12 hours. Now, what is the distance covered by the train in each hour? So, it is equal to 720 kilometer by 12 hours. So, the answer is 720 by 12. So, 60 kilometer per hour. Okay, children? So, can you say that the train has covered exactly 60 kilometer in each hour? No. Why? Why means? There may be some variation in distance covered by the train each hour. So, we take the average of distances covered by the train for each hour to decide its average speed. So, average speed, what is meant by average speed? The distance covered by an object in unit time is called average speed. So, average speed is equal to total distance by time taken. Total distance by time taken. So, let the displacement of the trip in show the above example 360 kilometer due to southwest direction. Direction is changed. So, here this one goes into this direction, southwest direction. So, now we have to calculate the displacement in each hour. So, the displacement per each hour is equal to 360 kilometer by 12 hours in southwest direction. So, 360 by 12. So, here 30 kilometer per hour in which direction? Southwest direction. So, the displacement of an object per unit time is called average velocity. What is meant by average velocity? The displacement of an object per unit time is called average velocity. So, average velocity is equal to displacement by time taken. What is the formula of average speed? Total distance by time taken. And what is the formula of average velocity? Displacement by time taken. Up to here, clear, children? So far we discussed about distance, displacement, speed, velocity, average speed, and average velocity. And I have told you that when you are driving a bike, when you are driving a bike, any person is asking you that what is the speed of a bike? then what is the speed of your bike and that movement, what is the values in the speedometer, and if you tell the some values to the person. And I told you that it is not a speed of a bike, that is a instantaneous speed. What is that? Instantaneous speed. Instantaneous speed of a bike. So what is instantaneous? What is instantaneous? Instant means at the moment of time. The point of the speedometer shows 60 km per hour. That is the speed of a bike at the moment. So instantaneous speed is instantaneous velocity or nothing but speeds or velocities. Okay children, so at that moment of the time, then how can you find numericals are given based on that? How can you find the numericals in physics? So many numerical problems are there, no ma? So then how we can find the numericals based on that? Here one graph is there. See in your textbook everybody. Here one graph is there. Now I have asked a question that what is the instantaneous speed at this point? Yes, see this one P. How do you find the answer at the point P? What is instantaneous speed? First see children, here y-axis is there, this one distance and time graph, y-axis, and this one is x-axis. Time, this one in x-axis, time is there, in y-axis distance is there. Now we have to draw like this graph. So here the time t1, t2 and t3, s1, s2, s3, here we have to draw like this. So this is the path of your bike. This is the path of your bike. This one x-axis and this one y-axis and this one x-axis. So here I have asked a question. What is the instantaneous speed at this point P? Here see. How do you find at the point P? How do you find? So we know that speed is equal to distance by time. Speed is equal to distance by time. So whenever based on the graph to find the instantaneous speed, then you have to draw a tangent. See here, tangent from that point. We have to draw a tangent from that point. This one is tangent. So after drawing a tangent, you have to take the slope of the tangent. You have to take the slope of the tangent. This one, AB is the tangent. So why we have to take the slope? Why we have to take the slope? Why means because in mass, slope is nothing but slope is in mathematical. We learn slope is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. It means y-axis by x-axis. We have y-axis distance and x-axis time. So distance by time is nothing but speed. Distance by time is nothing but speed. So from slope of a distance time graph we will get the speed. Now we have to find the slope of this line. We have to find this slope of this line. Now how do you find the slope of this line, children? Then how do you find the slope of this line? Here one method is there. Here one method is there. What is that? So listen carefully, children. Suppose the tangent is AB length. The tangent is AB length. So try to draw here bigger, longer tangent. Bigger means you have to extend this one, longer tangent. And take one scale and put a scale and draw a line which is horizontal to the time axis here. Here see children, you have to take one scale, put a scale and draw a line which is horizontal to the time. Time is there and horizontal you have to draw. one line with the help of a scale. Okay, children. Now take a scale, put it the point A, draw a line parallel to the distance axis. So yes, here too, again we have to put a one scale. You have to draw one line like this from A to here. So what happens both? So line intersecting here. Line intersecting point C. So once here, see children, slope y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, no? So in mathematical, we will take y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. By according to our graph, here y2 minus y1 means distance s2 minus s1. And x2 minus x1 means t2 minus t1. So here this intersecting point C. Now here ABC triangle, here formed one ABC triangle C. Like this. When you get a triangle, before I told here S2 minus S1 by T2 minus T1 is equal to AC by BC. So by using a scale, we will get instantaneous speed at point P. Got it, children? Up to here. So see, children, again, this one is horizontal line, vertical line means this one x-axis and y-axis, here time and distance. So distance versus time graph, this one. So here time intervals t1 and t2, here distance s1 and s2. Here this is the graph and we have to draw one tangent here, that one AB, and we have to calculate it here itself, and slope also we have to calculate. Slope is equal to S2 minus S1 by T2 minus T1. S2 minus, so average speed is equal to S2 minus S1 by T2 minus T1. That is, here ABC triangle is formed AC by BC. So, up to here clear? Then, we know the next one, velocity. So speed gives that idea of how fast the body moves. So in general, bodies move in a particular direction. It an instant of direction may be not be constant throughout the journey. So we need to define another quantity called velocity. Next we have to learn about the velocity. So, velocity is the speed of an object in specified direction. Suppose here, see, a car moves with 15 meter per second due to east direction. Here, 15 meter per second is speed and 15 meter per second due east is velocity. So, velocity gives the idea of how fast body moves in specified direction. So, in specified direction, velocity gives that idea of how the fast body moves in specified direction. So velocity is a vector. Before only I told velocity is a vector quantities. So it can be represented by a directed line segment. Here directed line segment. So its length indicates speed and arrows gives the direction of motion. So its length, it indicates the speed, and the arrows shows the direction of motion. Okay, children? So if a body moves in a curved path like this, so the body moves in a curved path, so the tangent drawn at a point on the curve gives the direction of velocity at that instant. So like this, this is in motion and we have to draw one tangent like this. And you have to draw the tangents to the curve at different points. So here I am taking one motion like this, and you have to draw one tangent. And again, another motion, we have to draw one tangent. So like this, you have to draw the motion like this and tangent like this. This one curved path and this one is tangent. Now observing the direction of a motion of a body. So a small object on the end of a string is the horizontal plane. Release the object while it is whirling on the string. So try to release the object at different points on the circle and observe the direction of a motion of object after has been released from the string. So the SI unit of velocity is meter per second. What are the SI units of velocity? Meter per second. So you will notice that object moving in a straight line along the tangent. The object is moving in a straight line along a tangent. So it is the circle at the point where you released. So the direction of a velocity is tangent to the path of a point of intersect. Clear, children? So the SI unit of velocity is meter per second. How to measure the average speed and average velocity? Here choose two points A and B. So the distance is 50 meters apart in a school playground. So ask some students to stand at point A. Ask another group of students with the stopwatches to stand at B. When you clap your hand, so the student at A start running towards the point B in any path. So at the same time, the students at B starts their stopwatches. So why means they have to noted the time. That's why they stop the watches. So here see this table. Students are A1, A2, A3 and time is T1, T2, T3. And average speed is 50 meters. Average speed is 50 meter per second. So now we have to calculate the average speed. How we have to calculate the average speed? What is the formula of average speed? Average speed is equal to total distance by time taken. So total distance 50. Three members here, they are participated. So that's why 50 plus 50 plus 50 by time. T1 plus T2 plus T3. Like that only you have to calculate the average speed. So the student who took the least time to reach B from A, is said to be the fastest runner. So the great, he or she has the greatest average speed. Then how to calculate the measuring the average velocity? So repeat the same activity. To draw a set of parallel straight lines A to B, and ask children to run along a line. They have to run along a line. So measure the time taken by each student and note it in the table. So in this one, these objects in the motion often have variations in their speeds. For example, car which travels along a street at 50 km per hour gets slowed down in 0 km per hour in red light, and then it attain a speed of 30 km per hour due to traffic on the road. Clear, children? Up to here, how to measure the average speed and average velocity. And here measuring the average velocity, we have to apply the formula displacement by time taken. And average speed, we have to apply total distance by time taken. So average velocity is equal to displacement by time taken. Average speed is equal to total distance by time taken. Now we discuss uniform and non-uniform motion. What are these uniform and non-uniform motions? Suppose you are in car. Once you close your eyes, now the car is moving on the road. When closed eyes, still you are not in the motion. That gives you are in car is moving in constant speed. When you close eyes and you feel you are falling towards right and towards left, that tells you that the bus is moving in variable speed. Yes or no? So first we discuss about the uniform motion. So first, what is meant by uniform motion? Children, when in previous class we already learned about the uniform motion. So what is the definition of uniform motion? Tell me. So when a body travels equal distances in equal intervals of time is called uniform motion. That means, here see, one boy is standing here, A, B, C, D, like this. So A to B distance 10 meters, C to D also 10 meters. So time A to B, he covered 5 seconds, here also 5 seconds, here also 5 seconds. So here equal distances and equal time intervals of time. This boy is covered equal distances in equal interval of time. So that's why this motion is called uniform motion. Once see here, so suppose consider a cyclist moving in a straight road. So the distance covered by him respect to the time, here they are given one tabular form, time and distance. So in time 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, and the distance he covered 0, 4, 8, 12, 16 like this. So this is the uniform motion. Here one graph is there, see in your textbook, ST graph, see, the straight line graph shows that the cyclist covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. From the graph, you can understand that the instantaneous speed is equal to average speed. So we have to understand about this graph, the instantaneous speed is equal to the average speed. So if the direction of a motion of the cyclist is assumed in the constant, then we conclude that velocity also constant. Here velocity also constant and instantaneous speed is equal to average speed. About so the motion of the body is said to be uniform when its velocity is constant. When the motion of your body is said to be uniform, so the motion of your body is said to be uniform when its velocity is constant. When its velocity is constant. Here see in your textbook, page number 9, one example they are given. See this one. So a man standing under a street lamp of height H above the ground starts running with a constant speed v in a constant direction. So the light from the lamp falling on the man forms a shadow of him. So find the velocity with which the edge of the shadow of the man is head moves over the ground if his height is small h. So here see the solution. Here we need to compare the motions of a man and the edge of the shadow of the man heads is head. So to solve this problem, you have to common starting point is necessary. Let the point is O. Here this is the common point. It is exactly under the lamp. So let a small s and capital S be the distances covered in time interval t from the point O. Small s, capital S be the distances. Okay. Now the man and the edge of a shadow of the man is head respectively. Here see. So you figure see triangle ABD. ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏబిడి అండ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏసిఓ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏసిఓ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏబిడి అండ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏసిఓ సో ఫ్రమ్ దీస్ టూ సిమిలర్ ట్రయాంగిల్స్ డిబి బై డిబి బై ఏడి డిబి బై ఏడి అండ్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఏసిఓ ఓసి బై ఏఓ ఓసి బై ఏఓ సో డిబి ఈజ్ స్మాలెస్ట్ అండ్ ఏడి క్యాపిటల్ హెచ్ మైనస్ హెచ్ సో ఎస్ బై హెచ్ మైనస్ హెచ్ అండ్ ఓసి ఈజ్ ఎస్ అండ్ ఏఓ ఈజ్ హెచ్ We know that small s is equal to Vt. So, we substitute here Vt by h minus s is equal to s by h. So, s by t is the speed v. So, the shadow of a man's head, then v is equal to hv by h minus h. This is about the uniform motion. Up to here, clear children? Did you understand? I hope all have followed the class. Tell me children, did you understand? Okay, so that's all for today's class children. We will meet into the next class. Once read the textbook part. Okay children, thank you. Have a nice day.